Hello friends, I hope you like my videos and it's helpful to enhance your knowledge. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the handling of deviation in pharmaceutical industry. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So now, what is deviation? So here are simple definition of deviation. That is, a deviation is any unwanted event that differs from the approved processes, procedures, instructions, specification or established standard. So in simple words, you can say any violation from the approved instructions or established standard procedure is called deviation. So deviation can occur during the manufacturing, packing, sampling and testing of drug products. So now in this slide we will discuss about the what are the regulatory guidelines for deviation, right? So first is FDA 21 CFR part 211.160. So this talks about the if any specification or procedure you are going to revise, that should be drafted by the appropriate organizational unit and should be reviewed and approved by the quality control unit, right? And any deviation from the written specification procedure, that should be there should be a control mechanism and it should be recorded and justified, right? So next is European guideline, that is good manufacturing practices guide part 1. So what it says, any significant deviation are fully recorded, investigated with objective of determining the root cause and appropriate corrective and preventive action should be implemented, right? And next is ICS Q10, that is pharmaceutical quality system. It says pharmaceutical companies should plan and execute a system for the monitoring or process performance and product quality to ensure state of control is maintained. An effective monitoring system provides assurance of continued capability of processes and control to produce a product of desired quality and to identify areas for continual improvement, complaints, product rejection, non-conformities, recalls, deviation, audits, regulatory inspection. So ICS Q10 talks about these all the things related to, right, which include the deviation. So now in this slide we will discuss the types of deviation, right? So there are two types of deviation, that is planned and unplanned deviations. So let's first discuss with planned deviation. So planned deviations are temporary deviation from an existing protocol or process that have been pre-approved, right? So deviation are planned in such a way that they do not compromise the safety and efficacy of your products, right? So the planned deviation should be evaluated by the cross-functional team and QA to ensure there should not be any impact on the product quality and thereby the patient's safety, right? So here are a few examples of planned deviations, such as change in batch size due to reduced availability of raw materials, change in batch size for a specified number of batches, change in supplier for excipients, right? So now second is unplanned deviation. So unplanned deviations are non-compliance with your design protocols or systems that occur at any stage of product's life cycle, that is including manufacturing, testing, holding, packaging and storage, right? So unplanned deviation are also referred to as unplanned events, uncontrolled events or incidents. So they can be caused by human error, utility failure, equipment or instrumentation breakdown or malfunctions, right? And here are a few examples of unplanned deviations, such as interruption of power supply resulting in equipment breakdown, accident at the site due to human error, right? Disruption of utility services, operator or analyst not followed this set of instruction or procedure, that is standard operating procedure, right? So now in this slide we will discuss the categorization of deviation, right? So there are three types of category for deviation, that is critical, major and minor deviation. So first let's discuss what is critical deviation. So any non-conformity from established standard procedure, that affects the quality of product and patient safety, which is highly probable, including life-threatening situations, such deviation is called critical deviation. Right. So critical deviation, it is like it will directly impact your patient safety, that includes the her or his life-threatening situation. Right. So here are example that is uses of contaminated raw material and solvents during manufacturing of medicines. Right. So this is the an example of the critical deviation. So next is major deviation. So any non-conformity from established standard procedure that affects quality of product and patient safety is unlikely is called the major deviation. That means in major deviation, it can be impact on your product quality, and also it is unlikely to impact the patient safety, right? So that is called major deviation. So machine breakdown during processing, this is an example of this major deviation, right? So next, third is minor deviation. So any non-conformity from established standard procedure that not impact product quality is called minor deviation, like spillage of material during dispensing. So in the minor deviation, those deviation which does not impact your product quality and the patient safety, right? So these are the critical, major and minor deviation. So now in this slide we will discuss about the handling of deviation, that is details of workflow of deviation, right? So first you need to initiate the deviation, then deviation will be reviewed by your user department head, then that deviation will go to the QA. So QA will initially they review that deviation, right? And accordingly they will comment. And then if the other department will be impacted due to that deviation, this will go to the other department, and finally it will go to the QA decision. So QA head will review that deviation, and based on that deviation initiation discrepancy, he will decide that this deviation is either in minor or major or critical category, right? And after that approval, make a decision from the QA. So user department head can propose an action plan based on that deviation, and further action plan shall be allocated to the respective users. And after allocation of that action plan execution will be done by the respective user, right? And also one important thing, because this is a deviation, so quality risk management you need to perform for that deviation which is observed, right? And after that quality risk management, you need to investigate that deviation. So detailed investigation you need to perform based on the types of deviation, right? And finally, you based on the investigation, you need to identify some root cause that may be probable or confirm root cause, right? And based on the root cause identification, you need to take a CAPA, right? And after that initiating the CAPA, so the action plan closure can be done, and effectiveness monitoring of this CAPA shall be initiated, and finally the deviation closure shall be initiated by the user department, and that deviation will go finally to the QA department, and QA head will finally close that deviation, right? So this is the actually handling of deviation detail, that is details of workflow from deviation initiation to final closure of deviation, right? So now in this slide we will discuss about the practical approach to make an investigation report for deviation, right? So first is the event description. So here you need to elaborate the problem statement, that is the description of deviation. For example, if you have lost some quality documents or it is misplaced, right? So for this deviation you need to describe the detail, that is problem statement here. And also you need to give the details such as deviation number. So deviation number can be assigned based on the internal procedure, right? And also you need to provide the details of product name, batch number, stage, date of occurrence, date of initiation, SOP number if applicable, and who has identified the deviation and how it was identified, and where the event was identified. So such things you need to elaborate here in the event description, right? Next is immediate action. So here you need to describe about the action you have taken immediately after identification of deviation. So for example, the misplaced quality documents, you search that document at their respective places or in the files, and you have escalated this deviation to the department head and QA head, and you have initiated that event, and right. So such kind of things you need to elaborate in the immediate action, right? Next is initial impact assessment. So here you need to elaborate about the initial impact with respect to the product quality and impact on batches, right? So here you can give the rationale that misplaced document is control copy and master copy is available, or it is available in the electronic format. So such kind of things you can elaborate here, right? So the next is investigations team. So here you need to define about who are involved into the investigations, such as name of person, their department, their designation, right? So such kind of things you need to elaborate. So now next is investigation findings. So in this, first is process flow. So here you need to define about the process step details and what can be the possible error to misplace the documents, right? Next is historical checks. So here you need to provide the details of similar type of deviation with root cause and kappa. So you can consider the last 2 year data to check the same type of deviation and provide the details, right? Next is root cause assessment. So here first you need to elaborate about your preliminary investigation details that is performed, and what you have done to search that documents, or where you have searched that document. So step by step manner you need to elaborate, right? Next is extended investigation. So here the details of further investigation by using the various tools to find out the root cause, such as 5Y, fishbone diagram, FMEA, fault tree, hypothesis. So such kind of tools you need to use to perform the detailed investigation. So these are the, you know, very lengthy topics. So I will make another video to discuss these all tools for the investigation related, right? Now next is human evaluation. So if root cause it identifies as a human error, then name of person, their employee code, and what error he or she done. So such details we need to mention if it is applicable, if your identified root cause related with the human error, right? Next is root cause conclusion. So here based on the detailed investigation, you need to elaborate the root cause details. So it may be that inappropriately handling of documents and due to which it was misplaced. So this is just an example I am giving. So right, so you can make the root cause conclusion in this section, right? Next is impact assessment based on the root cause identified, right? So impact on batch or any other things you need to elaborate here. So like about the details of impact with respect to the product or batches, right? Since this is a case of mishandling of document, and document may available as a master copy or in electronic format, so by giving such rationale we can say there will not be any impact on product or batches, right? So all these what I have explained is just an example. However, there may be the other scenario also, right? Next is kappa and its effectiveness monitoring. So here you need to describe about the what correction, corrective action and preventive action taken based on the identified root cause, and also you need to perform the effectiveness monitoring of this kappa, right, to check the kappa taken is effective or not in the future. So such things you need to done, right? So friends, this is all about the deviation. I hope it will help to understand the concept, right? So thank you so much for the watching video.